गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन एंड वेलकम टू अरोरा ऑनलाइन क्लासेस. डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई एम विद अ न्यू लेसन फॉर यू एंड द नेम ऑफ द लेसन इज अ हाउस इज नॉट अ होम. इट्स फ्रॉम मोमेंट्स एंड इट्स बाय जैन गॉडियोसो. अ हाउस इज नॉट अ होम. Actually, this story focuses on the need of love, affection, and care that is necessary to turn a house into a home. And we all know love without love and affection is useless. Love without, I mean to say, life without love and affection is meaningless. There is no value. So actually, the author describes a childhood incident when he joined a new school, and he tells how terribly sad and lonely he felt without friends at this school. So to make the matter worst, his house got burnt and he and his mother became shelterless. They lost their house and they were nowhere. So their condition was quite miserable, and most importantly, he lost his favorite cat in the fire. He felt miserable without the cat. And it was then that people came to help them. So let's go for it. How he feels, what happened to the narrator. When we talk about a house, house is mere a building of bricks and stones. A house is not a home. Then what is home? A house changes into home when there is love and affection among the members of the family. Otherwise, it is mere a building of bricks and stones. So love is needed, affection is needed, cooperation is needed, support is needed among the members of the family. Then a house becomes a home. So what is needed for a house to be home? Love is needed, support is needed, affection is needed, cooperation is needed. So let's go for it. So let's go for the summary of the story. Love for the old school. As I have said right now, the author describes his childhood incident. The author recalls his days at the high school. He was sad, lonely, and friendless. He missed his classmates, teachers, and the old school building. His new school was twice bigger than the old one. His old friends had joined some other school. His old teachers, whom he visited, advised him to involve himself in the new school activities. They asked him to come and meet them whenever he liked. Now, point number two, house on fire. So it was one cold Sunday afternoon. The author was doing his homework while his favorite cat was sitting beside him, and fire was burning in the fireplace. The author's mother stopped the fire. Suddenly, the author saw a smoke coming from the ceiling. The smoke increased, and his mother and he came out in front yard. Their house was on fire. Means the house was on fire. The fire spread in no time. The author's mother ran back into the house, and then she was able to save some important documents. And in order to get some pictures and letters of her husband, she dared to go again in the house. Actually, the author's mother, the narrator's mother, was a widow. She had lost her husband much earlier, but she was still attached with her husband. That is why, without caring for her life, she went inside the house to get those pictures and letters of her husband, and she saved them. Then point number three, visit of the firemen. The firemen were summoned, they were called. One of them went in the house to save the author's mother. So she was brought out, she was put in the truck with an oxygen mask over her mouth, and then she was out of danger. The narrator's mother was saved, and she had only inhaled a little more smoke. The author was wrapped in a blanket and seated in a car. So both the mother and the son, the author, were saved. Because the firemen came for their help, the firemen came for their rescue, and both of them were rescued. Meanwhile, what happened? The author, the narrator, had a cat, and it was a friendly cat. So it was his favorite cat. So fire was put out after 5 hours. The house was completely destroyed. Everything got burnt down, and the cat was found nowhere. The narrator thought that it must have been died in the fire. It must have been burnt in the fire. And then the author was so much emotionally attached with the cat that he started crying. And the author with his mother went to his grandparents for the night. Point number five, feelings of loneliness and dejection. The author felt like an outcast. He went to school in a bad condition. He had lost everything. He had lost his house. He had lost his bag. He had lost his books. He has lost his uniform. Everything was burnt. Now he had no shoes, no books, no backpack. He was in old dress. He wanted to die. He was so upset. He was so lonely. He was so depressed and sad, because he had lost everything. So he walked through his house and found nothing intact. His heart cried for the missing cat. He missed his cat a lot. Now, the rubble was cleared. The people, next point is helpful people. When people in the school came to know of the author's condition, the author was taken to the gymnasium. And there in the gymnasium, in the school, he was gifted all the necessary things. He was gifted clothes, notebooks, jeans, tops, sweat suits, and he felt greatly touched by this gesture. He was provided everything what was needed for him. So for the first time, he got the cooperation of the people in the school. All the teachers, the principal, and the students, actually, they cooperated with the narrator, and they provided him everything. This was for the first time he came to know about the support of the people. This was for the first time he came to know, or he got to understand the importance of support and cooperation. And he was touched by their gesture, by their help, by their support. And then he made new friends at this school. Now life back to normal again. He saw his home. Now his house was completely destroyed. It was damaged. Then He saw his house being rebuilt. Now his house was being rebuilt, reconstructed. A month later, he was in his house. Again, two of his friends were there to see him. The fire had brought a new change in the life of the narrator. He only missed the cat. Now everything became normal. But he was missing his cat because the cat was nowhere. And the author was under the impression that the cat has died in the fire. So now he was happy with his old friend. He was happy with the newfound company of friends. Point number 8, the cat restored by a woman. One day, a woman came and restored him his lost cat. The author became very happy and took the cat in his hands and cried. He became very emotional. The cat also purred happily. The cat had actually run away a mile away when the fire engulfed the house. So the cat, on that day, the cat escaped from there to save its life. As the cat had a collar with their phone number on it, the women came to know about the owner of the cat on the basis of the phone number. So she took care to carry the cat, and the cat curled up in the author's lap. The author felt very happy to get the cat back from that woman. All old feelings of sadness and loneliness disappeared, and he felt really very comfortable again. I mean to say that the narrator was, earlier he was very sad and lonely. He had missed his cat, but now he got his cat back, and he was really very much touched when he got the cat back from the woman. So this is a story. He understood the importance of support and cooperation. He came to know about the importance of his friends, and everything was there with the narrator. His life became normal. So a house is not a home. A house becomes home when there is love, when there is support, when there is the atmosphere of joy, when there is a sense of cooperation among the members of the family. So without love, support, affection, without these things, a house is mere a building of bricks and stones. A house becomes home when there is love. A house becomes home when there is support. A house becomes home when there is affection. So when the people live together happily and peacefully, then the building of bricks and stones becomes a suitable place to live in. Then it becomes a home. So with this, the lesson comes to its end. Thank you very much, students. I hope whatever I have taught you, it is clear to you. That's all for today.